Anonymous says causes for night sweats in men. Any thoughts on that?
It can be hormonal, just like it can be for women. So I test all the same hormones in men. I check their thyroid with night sweats. I definitely even check same thing. I check cortisol and I do norepinephrine markers with night sweats. And this is also assuming that I don't suspect cancer, because night sweats can be a keynote, especially in men. Night sweats can be a keynote for cancers. And so I want to make sure I'm not suspicious of that, but it's the same for women: blood sugar issues, hormone issues, cortisol issues, and making sure you're not sleeping in an extra hot room, which, because men can get hot, there are night sweats from being overheated, just like women can, you know, sort of those basic things too.
I just got a chili pad. I've been thinking.
I've been wanting to try one. What do you think?
I've been thinking about getting a chili pad for years.
Yeah.
And I went to a little conference where the guy who invented the chili pad was there. And he let me borrow one for the night. And I bought the chili pad. in fact, if I were any of you, I would not buy the chili pad. I would pre-order the Uller, which is their new model that's shipping in June. And but I wanted it so badly that I bought the chili pad with the intention to buy the new model when it comes out in June. But in the new model, you're going to be able to control from the app, like it's at least hour by hour. It might be minute by minute when you want the temperature to go up and down. And there's a warm to wake function. So it just gradually increases in warmth by, you know, leading up to when you want to wake up, which ties in nicely with the data from a few years ago showing that in hunter gatherers who sleep outside, they wake up before the sunrise with the increase in core temperature being, which is driven by the increase in ambient temperature as you near the sunrise. That is the key trigger for the waking. So that's a natural function in it. And also I think there's a lot of people who sleep much better at a temperature that is colder than the temperature that they fall asleep at.
I totally agree.
And so you can't currently make the timing function with the current model of the chili pad, but with the one that's coming out in June, you will be able to, and you'll be able to set it so that it goes to maybe like 65 or whatever feels comfortable to you while you're actually, you can warm it to 110.
Wow.
Wow. You could have it, you know, if 75 is comfortable to you when you're falling asleep, and you can have it so that 20 minutes later it goes down to 55, which is not the temperature that it feels like the room is. It's the temperature of the water circulating in it. So ambient temperature, like 64 is my best temperature to sleep at, but I keep the chili pad at 55 because but what I noticed was I will usually have complete insomnia at anything above 72-ish. I'll have great difficulty at 70, and 72, 74 is the threshold where I just will not fall asleep.
Right.
And I can have my room as hot as 80 and sleep well if the chili pad is set at 55. And so I'm really excited about that for the summer, because I think that it's much less stress on the air quality to not have to run the air conditioner as much. Mm-hmm. And also the way my room is set up, it's really hard to have the AC on and not having it blow on me while I'm in bed. Mm-hmm. So I think I'm just super excited about it. And
I wrote it down.
Throw it out there if you're going to bring up the room temperature for the night sweats.
Yeah, absolutely. So, yeah.